I used to want to rap. Not necessarily because I used to have a love for rapping. I love rap music, but I didn't necessarily have a love for rapping. I just saw it working for other people. So I used to be at this recording studio called TNT Records, and I met this guy named Willie Will. He did weekends at Z93 Jam. I just used to hear him all the time. And I remember just asking him, like, yo, how'd you get on the radio? And he was like, yo, I went down there and I got an internship. And I was like, yo, is that easy? So I went down there and I filled out an internship, and they gave it to me. That internship eventually evolved into, you know, me having a part-time job. And it was just because when I would go there at that internship, I would, like, bust my ass, like, literally bust my ass. I did that for a while. And Ron White, who was the music director at the time, he asked me, did I want to be on the air? I just was like, yeah. And that's when kind of like the bug like really, really bit me, man. This felt like, yo, this is mine. Like, I'm really amongst my air likes right now because I really love this radio thing. And I remember, man, you know, they started putting me in different time slots. And I remember being there like midnight to 5 in the morning. And I just got caught in this wormhole of radio personalities. Like, I started listening to old Howard Stern stuff and listening to Big Tigger and listening to Star and Buck, listening to Sway, old Petey Green stuff. And I was like, yo, if I am gonna really be serious with this radio thing, I wanna be like them. And not like them as far as personality-wise. I wanted to be like them as far as just being super jocks.